Hi everyone, and thanks for watching 3dmotive.com. My name is Cordell Felix, and on this video, I will show you how to use Headus UV Layout. Headus is a great tool to help unwrap a model very quickly and get great results. It can be used to unwrap both organic and hard surface models with ease. I use Headus to unwrap every model that I make that needs to be used for baking and texturing. Headus can save a lot of time compared to unwrapping straight in 3ds Max or Maya or any other modeling program really. For me, Headus helps bring back the artistic side of unwrapping compared to unwrapping in a modeling program where it can feel to get a little technical sometimes. I will be using Headus UV Layout version 2 for this video, which has a couple features that allow me to unwrap things orthogonally. This video assumes that you have a basic knowledge of what unwrapping a model is to be used for baking and texturing. I'm going to be using this mask to demonstrate how to unwrap quickly. This model has both hard surface and organic elements, which will help me show how powerful Headus is. The first thing we need to do is to export our low poly mesh as an OBJ. So I'm gonna export my mesh now as an OBJ. And I'm gonna call it mask unwrap me. This just tells me that I need to unwrap this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and export it. Okay. Now let's bring it into Headus. So I have the folder open where the OBJ went. And what I like to do, I like to just drag the OBJ right into Headus, and it'll load it up for me. So I'm going to go to New and Clean. This just tells me that I'm going to have new UVs. If I was to do Edit, it would. This is good for models that are already unwrapped, and you just need to edit. It's usually good to have the Clean box checked. So I'm just going to do New and hit Load. So I'm going to make this window bigger for the sake of this tutorial. And now we have our mesh in here. The Headus interface is very easy to use and to navigate in. Left click allows you to rotate the model, middle mouse click allows you to drag the model around or move it, and right click drag allows you to zoom in and out of the model. How Headus works is by letting us split edges that we want to be separate, pelt elements, and have minimal distortion on the unwraps. It allows us to fully customize our unwrap with a couple hotkeys. Splitting edges helps you decide how the unwrap will look. When you are ready to unwrap each element, you have to drop them into the unwrapping area. And I'm going to drop this to show you what that is. And this is where you'll be unwrapping things. So I will be pelting mostly everything, and I can orthogonally unwrap stuff. So I'm going to drop this back to here. So let's start unwrapping this thing now. I know that I want to unwrap this front face first, so I'm going to drag that out. And by dragging elements around, I'm going to hold down spacebar and then middle mouse click drag. And that's going to allow me to drag the element around. You can do that. You can just hold spacebar and just drag things out like that. So I'm going to focus on this face. So I'm going to click on it once and then hit the home key. And that's going to like kind of isolate it so where I can just rotate around it on its own axis. And now I'm going to begin to split the edges. I wanted to split some edges now. So if I hover over an edge and press C, it will give me a cut. The red line is where you decide the cut will start, and the yellow line is trying to complete the loop as if it was trying to make it easier for me so I don't have to select each individual edge, like kind of like this. So it's nice that the yellow line kind of completes that. So pressing C will cut and pressing W will weld if you made a mistake or don't want to, or if you don't want the loop to go in a certain direction. So say if I wanted this loop to kind of go the other way, wherever this yellow goes, I can turn this and go this way, and I can weld up here. So pressing W will weld. And so when I'm ready to split, I will press Shift S, and this will split the line in half, which will ultimately split the UVs. I'm going to do this now on these pinches in the end here, so I'm just going to undo this. So I know that this is going to pinch a lot in the UVs, so I'm just going to cut here. And I know I want it to end up here, so I'm going to weld this up here, and then split, Shift S. And there's a pinch here that I want to get rid of. And there you go. Now I need to drop this into the unwrapping area. I drop things by pressing D, and then when I press 1, it will show me where it's been dropped. Pressing Shift D will undrop this back into the area I was just in if I wanted to make any edits to the splits. So when I drop it, press 1 to go to the other area, and then if I undrop it, press 2 to go back to the other area. I'm going to drop this back in to unwrap it. And I know that I want to pelt this out, which Headus is great at. To pelt, I have to press and hold F, and this allows the pelt to keep working. If I tap F, it's just going to move a couple of frames and then stop, and then move a couple of frames and stop. So if I hold, it'll keep going until I let go. For some complex meshes, it's best to press Shift plus F, which will do a boundary pelt. This basically takes the border of the mesh and releases it to shrink to a nice pelt. To release the boundary, I press and hold spacebar, which it tells me at the top left here, and it'll let go. And then it'll conform to whatever pelt or whatever shape it is. And then you hold space again to stop. And that's final. There's a few things to point out now that I have this pelted out. You can see the blue and the red colors, which indicate stretching and squashing. The green is safe, and you can get away with the soft red and the soft blue colors. I can show you what the UVs look like when I press 3 to view a texture template on it. Let me stretch one part of it first before I go to the scene. So I'm going to stretch this area up here and just make it all wonky so I can see what the texture looks like. When I press 3, it will bring me into a scene where there are meshes unwrapped. You can see the rest of the mesh is white, which means it's not unwrapped yet. You can cycle through the texture templates by pressing T, and I can scale them up or down using the plus and minus sign. This will help show me if there is any weird stretching that is going on and that needs fixing. You can see that the area that I stretch out up here is definitely stretching out a lot of the text. So you can it's squashing it there, and it's stretching these. So it looks like the blue is squashing and the red is stretching. So if I go back and fix that, I'll just pelt this out by holding F. And I go back to this scene. You can see that it's fixed most of the errors. I got some blue here still. So if I just pelt it a little bit more. We'll go back to 3, and it's pretty good. You can see that a soft blue is passable. So by pressing 1, it'll bring me to the unwrapping area. Pressing 2 will get me to the drop area. And pressing 3 will take me to the unwrapped parts of the mesh to view textures on. I like this texture template the most because it shows me the numbers, and it's easier to tell if a number is stretching or squashing, whereas these two other textures doesn't really tell me much. This is nice also if I scale up. Just gives you a good idea of what your unwrap is going to look like. There's some more sweet tips about messing around with an unwrapped piece. I was doing some specific stretching on the top part here and was doing some other stuff without explaining. I'll show you how to do that now. There are tons of little things that can be done during the stage. I'm going to bring in another piece first before I start, and I wanted to bring in one of these rings here. One of these guys. So I wanted it to be split across this entire edge here. Oh, and another thing, because you can see here, I'm trying to rotate around this, and it's not really letting me because I have all those other elements here. So if I click on the element that I want and then hit home, it's going to kind of zoom in on it, and I can rotate around it, like on its own axis. So now that I know that, I'm going to hit Shift S to split, and then I'm going to drop this in by hitting D. And you can see it here. The reason why I brought this ring in is because I know it's going to be an orthogonal unwrap. So instead of pelting this out like I would before, or doing this Shift F thing boundary, I want it to be straight. So I can press R, which will do a completely orthogonal unwrap. And if I hold F, it's gonna pelt it and kind of take care of it. So you can see it's perfectly straight. It's making these big black bordered lines, which kind of tells me that it's gonna hold it in place no matter what. These bordered lines tells me that it's going to unwrap perfectly vertical and horizontal. This is my favorite tool in Headus. I can really solve these by pressing Control-I, and I can bring back individual lines by pressing I, or if I just hover and hold I and drag, I can select multiple at one time. Pressing Shift-I will make a loop, and then pressing Control-I will make a ring. This is perfect for hard surface props that need to have straight UVs to texture on. So say if I wanted the borders to be straight, I could just select the outside edges. So let me get rid of these by pressing Control-I. So let me just select these outside edges by holding Shift-I and then looping everything. Kind of like that. If I pelt this out now by holding F, it will constrain the bordered edges and have the inside edges conform or change. Rotating, scaling, and moving around a UV island works sort of the same as the drop scene. So if I wanted to rotate this, I would hold down spacebar and then left click drag, and I can rotate this. And if I wanted to move it around, I could hold spacebar and then middle mouse click move. If I wanted to scale it, I hold spacebar and right click up and down. So that's how that works. What I like to do, mostly for these orthogonal pieces, if you hold down control and then tap like a directional arrow, like down or right, you can see that it's going to move exactly how that line is. So if I was to go on the slanted one and then hold control and press down, it's going to make that line straight or perfectly right. It depends on what line you're going to do it on. So if I wanted this to be straight, I will go to this border and then press control left or right. I wanted to note that there is no clicking involved. All you have to do is just hover over the line and then do your hotkey. So this is me just hovering. I'm not doing any sort of clicking or any of that. I'm just hovering over the edge. And it's the same for when you press I and all that other stuff. Let's hop back to the face mask to show some of the pelting tricks. So I'm going to straighten this out first by selecting this line and then making it straight. Okay. If I hold down control and then hold right click, I can move a vertex. And if I hold down shift and then right click, I can softly move an area around. This is great for massaging some of the blue and red colors out to be green. So say if I wanted to be have these red areas be more green, I can massage these out and kind of stretch it out a bit, kind of like that. But I'll take more time definitely. If I press and hold O, I can do an area relax, which is very useful. I use this a lot. So areas like this where it's squashing, I can press and hold O and it'll conform those down. So instead of holding F to pelt everything out, I can just do one area like this. Let's unwrap one of the horns now. This gives a great example of how sometimes something just doesn't want to pelt out right. So we have to force it to pelt out. So let's press 2 and then go to one of the horns. I'm just going to pick this horn right here, this back one. So I'm going to hit home. And I'm going to split the back area because I know that's where I want the UVs to split. I don't want it to go all the way up. So let's stop it there. And hit Shift S to split. And then let's drop it. Okay, there it is. So if I wanted to pelt this out, I know it's gonna pelt out a little bit weird like that. And I think that even if I hold do the boundary pelt, it's gonna still do some funky stuff. So this happens sometimes. So what I found to do is just force it to be straight. This is nice because it gives me a little bit of control of my unwrap. It doesn't make it feel so technical. This makes it feel a bit more artistic. So to force this to be right, I have to hold shift and then hold right click to kind of pull this out. So pulling that out means that when I pelt it out, it's going to make it straight. It's literally forcing those parts out, and then when I pelt it, it's gonna squish them back. So I can do this any way I want. I could try to make this curve this way, like that, and then pelt it, and it'll start to be a shape that I want it to be. This works for other things as well, like say for this thing. If I want it to be like a U shape, I could just pull this down and then pelt it, and then it'll do that. I'm gonna continue unwrapping some more parts real quick and finish this video up. So let's just unwrap a couple more horns. So let's do this back one. I do this sometimes too because when I do the orthogonal, I will then release all the boundaries and then I'll hold F to pelt it, and it'll give me that natural shape, and I kind of want that natural shape for when I do baking the normals because if I do this completely straight, I will get a lot of wavy lines in the normal, so I'll release that and then pelt it out. Unwrap some more parts. I know that this big ring is going to be kind of a problem, so I'm just going to make it completely straight when I unwrap it. So let's unwrap and drop each part. This would be kind of a big pain to do the release boundary, or even if I was to do this, it's just going to be a pain. So it's easier to just press R once and make orthogonal, and then release the boundaries, and then pelt it. That way it's nice and straight. So for this one, you know, instead of pelting, just press R and done. And I'm releasing the boundaries so that it kind of keeps its natural shape. And it's still very straight. If I wanted to, I could, you know, move around this thing. I could shape it however I want. Like that. And then there you go. Kind of messes the shape. And most of these other parts, they're pretty symmetrical. They're kind of the same thing. So I'm not going to unwrap all of them because most of them are going to be sharing the same UVs, stuff like that. So now I'll show you how to do a very quick auto pack, which is very nice. It's very useful. I use this sometimes for an asset that needs to be done very quickly, or I'll even do it just for real quick, and then I'll repack it in Max. I'm going to move this window off to the side now because I need this window here to do the auto pack. So I'm going to go into the unwrap area to where all my other things are unwrapped. And I just want to do a very quick auto pack. So I'm going to go to pack, and then I'm going to go to best, and then I'm going to allow it to rotate whenever I want. The bleed is, I'm going to change that to about 2. And shrink boxes to fit, that's fine. And then just hit pack all, and it'll do its little thing. It'll pack everything. It's going to tell you how many seconds it's been since its last improvement here at the bottom left, and you can hold spacebar to stop whenever you want. So you can see that it did its best job to pack everything. And for some assets that I'm doing very quickly that I need to finish the same day, I will do this, and then I will bring it back into Max, then I'll repack it on my own. Or if it's very quick, I'll just leave it how it is, and I'll texture it how it is. And a couple last little things is, I forgot to mention that I didn't really like the pinch split, so you can actually still weld vertices in here just by hitting W, and then I can repelt those areas back out. If I hold O, I can shrink those back in. So you can still make the edits in the unwrap if you wanted to. I can even go in here and cut and hit Shift S, or actually you cut and then you hit Enter to split. So those are a couple of things that you can also know. So it's very customizable, it's very editable. And also, if you wanted to redrop something, I've had times where I hit Shift D in an open area, and that you can't really do anything after that for some reason, because it's telling you these little error at the bottom left. So if you hit Enter to abort, it's going to allow you to move everything again. So if you ever do anything in an open area by accident, it's going to give you an error. You can also set how long you want the unwrap to go for. So if I can set it for 5 minutes, then hit Pack All, and then I could walk away, and then come back, and then the unwrap will be done. When you're ready, you can just go ahead and hit save, and then click save, and it is done. So you can hit dismiss, and then exit, and you're good to go. And that about wraps it up for this quick tip. This is the final result of how the mask turned out. It was unwrapped fully in Headus, then finished in Photoshop, and then rendered afterwards. My name is Cordell Felix, and thanks again for watching 3dmotive.com.